saying is like a question and like a contribution.
Go ahead.
As they are parading themselves in this 2023 conquest of evil present and this, is it not wise enough for us to seal down anything about campaign, anything about whatever that their ambition in the Biafran land? Because the more we give them that space to do their campaign and do whatever rubbish they are doing, they are thinking that they have arrived. Can't we stop every campaign in Igbo land? Because we are not part of Janjawis and we cannot allow their campaign in our land.
Yes, what you have said is absolutely critical. But there is one mistake we don't want to make. There is one mistake we are not going to make. The mistake is this. You don't know these people. You know that democracy and democratic discourse is a universal concept, or should I say, that is what the West is trying to, should I say, promote all over the world. What they want to do, what they want to do, in essence, is to try as much as possible to say that we are anti-democratic forces. That's what they want to do. Once you say to the US, to EU, and all the rest of them that these people do not believe in democracy, you become an enemy of the world. That is why we cannot take that very route. But if they rig any elections that they have, then we have every legitimate right to express our grievances. But I do understand what you're saying. Our Yoruba brethren are saying also that there's not going to be any elections in 2023 unless, you know, they discuss referendum, which is where we stand at the moment. But we must be very, very careful not to do anything that will allow the zoo to go to the Biden administration or to go for Britain to help them to go to Europe to say that these are anti-democratic forces. Once we do that, they will try as much as they can to shut us down. So we must proceed very, very cautiously. Very, very cautiously. Thank you very much. Thank you very, very much for that. They are, of course, you know, the useless Facebook. They are cracking and trying to make our life difficult, as always. They are trying to make our life difficult, as always. But we are going to stop them. They can't stop us from broadcasting this very morning. They can never, ever stop us from broadcasting this very morning. We are live and we are direct, and heaven is bearing us witness. Let me go to the line to see who is there. If you are used to calling, please, I beg of you, allow other people to try and call as well. We cannot afford to appear undemocratic. Once you do, that is over. If you have called us in the past couple of months, please try not to call us again. Please allow other people, other first-time callers, to call as well, please. Very, very important. Allow other first-time callers to call us as well, please. I have a caller on the line. Please give us your name and where you're calling us from, if you may.
Good morning, my leader. Good morning from here. My name is Pastor Jack. I'm calling from the zoo. I just like my last brother, my leader, just asked. All of us understand that most of the difficulties we are going through now are the governors in Biafra land. Because even when they launch this Ebube Nkita that we don't know, our local radio stations in our land, when they presented this issue, majority of the people from our land that called the radio station says, ESN is already doing the work. What are you forming Ebube Agu for? Because the way ESN is doing it, we don't think any other person can do it that way. Even the Janjaweed army, because ESN is following these people head up and making sure our land, our bushes and forests are rid of this Janjaweed. So the question now, like that my brother asked, what strategy and methodology are we going to use to follow this governor? Because the truth is, these people have sold their conscience. They are determined to work with the enemy, the fleeing Janjaweed, to make sure they scuttle our freedom. Is there no way we can handle these people while we are waiting for that right time? Because these people are definitely spoiling something for us, my leader. That is my question this morning, sir.
We are doing all we can. It's not everything for obvious reasons that we're going to announce live on air. You know, but what we're doing is that we have a strategy in the fullness of time to checkmate all these traitors and saboteurs within our midst. They can form Ebube, whatever. As I said, they formed Ogunigwe last year, didn't work. Now they are forming Ebube, as you said, Ebube Nketa, this very year, Ebube Ochicha. And it's now also going to fly because they need men to be able to do the work for them. And they do not have it because everybody, as you well know, is loyal under this very command. They understand that. Both those who identify with IPOB and those who don't, we are all IPOB in the end. And we are under one command. Everybody, I mean absolutely everybody. Those who are fathered by the Janjaweed may try all they can. They may do all within their powers to try to stop what we are doing. They have not succeeded in the past. They will not succeed now. They can form whatever they like. In the end, as you well know, we always win. If our Yoruba brethren today can be campaigning very determinedly and resolutely for the freedom of the Yoruba nation, that tells you all you need to know, that we have won the argument. We have won the argument. And we must proceed, should I say, very cautiously. We are at a very critical juncture right now. We don't want to do anything that will allow them to go to the world and say, oh, did we not tell you? This is who they are. This is how the Biafra is going to be. Why do you think they floated this Ebubochicha? It's because they want an internecine warfare within the Biafran family so that the world will say, oh, can you see them? If you give them freedom, this is how they're going to behave. We know how the Fulanis operate. I wouldn't even be shocked nor surprised if they have a hand in the flare-up of the boundary dispute that is happening in Izaa right now. That's led to the, should I say, loss of life of very innocent people. But we are on top of our game, and they understand what is coming. And as I said, it's just a matter of time, and it will happen. When I was telling people about the zoo, army, and police, you didn't believe me. I said, a time will come when they will not be on our streets. Today, they are not there anymore. If they are on our streets, they will die. They understand it very, very clearly. And today, our streets are clear. So one day, I'm telling you, you shall look for saboteurs. You will never find them. One day, you will look for all these traitors. You can never find them. Because they'll be dealt with. Thank you very much for calling. Thank you very, very much for calling.
My simple question is this. With the manner our governors are doing in the land of Biafra, the way other people are sabotaging us, doing everything humanly possible, aiding and abetting, serving the Fulani Janjaweed to get their conquest. I am suggesting, is it not high time we give them a shaking hand so that when others see that we have attacked them, they have a visible attack on them or anything that is connected and related to them, I think it will help us and give a warning to other people who might migrate newly to do the same thing they are doing.
That is true. I entirely agree with you, but that time hasn't come yet. What we are doing right now is to face the enemy. But all the traitors and saboteurs within, when their time comes, they'll be dealt with. In fact, some of them are being dealt with as we speak. But it's not everything that we're going to announce live on air. And they understand it, that our freedom is of paramount importance. We want nothing else more than our freedom. There is nothing else we desire more than the freedom for we Biafrans. And we are going to do, we are doing everything humanly possible to make sure that that's the case. Thank you very much for calling. Thank you very, very much for calling.
Again, sir, that's